Fortune and Silk Touch are two of the most useful enchantments in Minecraft, unlocking massive efficiency benefits and otherwise unobtainable materials, with a wide range of applications. But these enchantments are also incompatible. So should you go through the trouble of making and enchanting two full sets of tools, one with Fortune and one with Silk Touch? Or are some combinations not useful enough to justify the cost? Welcome to Cube Figured, I'm the Tuned Cube. In this video, we'll be investigating the usefulness for survival gameplay of Fortune and Silk Touch enchantments on each of the four main tools. Now, you might be wondering what these enchantments do that make them such a big deal in the first place. Generally speaking, they both affect the items that drop when certain blocks are mined. The Fortune enchantment increases the chance of items dropping, which on average increases the number of items dropped. There are three levels of Fortune, with Fortune 3 being the most rewarding. The Silk Touch enchantment causes a block to drop itself as an item, instead of the different item it drops when mined without Silk Touch. Many blocks aren't affected at all by either of these enchantments. Among those that are, there are some that are affected by both Fortune and Silk Touch. Because both affect item dropping behavior in contrasting ways, a tool cannot be enchanted with both Fortune and Silk Touch, only one or the other. If these two buffs were not mutually exclusive, it would be possible to, for example, break a diamond ore block and get multiple diamond ore items, which could themselves yield multiple ores each, leading to infinite diamonds. And that would make Minecraft a much different game. If you're looking for more details about the effects of these enchantments, like the exact fortune drop rates for each item, the Minecraft Wiki summarizes that information pretty clearly, so I've put links to those pages in the description. What the wiki doesn't summarize clearly at all is the usefulness of each of the 8 tool enchantment combinations. So let's dive in. Here are the uses of a fortune enchanted hoe. On the left side, we have the block being broken. On the right, the item or items that drop. And in between, I'm using these lovely pink glazed terracotta arrows to show the transformation. Yes, this is quite a short list, and it's all about leaves. All leaf types drop sticks and their corresponding saplings more often when mined with a fortune hoe, and oak and dark oak leaves also drop apples more often. This is great for manual tree farming, especially of jungle trees, because their leaves drop saplings less often than the other varieties. However, leaves do drop enough saplings on average, without fortune, to support a self-sustaining farming process. If you have a semi-automatic tree farm, you probably won't use a fortune hoe ever again. Sticking with the hoe, let's look at the uses of Silk Touch. Here, the item dropped is the same as the block being broken, so no need for any arrows. Before the addition of the deep dark materials in 1.19, the Silk Touch hoe was practically useless. But now it's the essential tool for exploring ancient cities and doing vibration-based redstone. This is a good place to note that while some blocks only drop items when mined with the correct tool, many blocks can be mined with multiple types of tools and still successfully drop items. For these blocks, there is typically a primary tool that works best, and using a secondary tool incurs a penalty of speed or durability. In this video, I'm categorizing blocks based on their primary tool only. Moving on, we have the Fortune Shovel. The Fortune Shovel is only useful for flint mining, and large quantities of flint are only useful for crafting arrows. Since skeleton farms can renewably produce tons of arrows, the Fortune Shovel is pretty much useless, unless you're playing in peaceful mode. The Silk Touch Shovel is much more useful, since it can be used to acquire grass blocks, mycelium, and podzol, which otherwise only drop dirt when mined. Silk Touch also eliminates the chance of flint dropping from gravel, ensuring 100% gravel drops, which makes it easier to get large quantities of concrete. A quick note here on the differences between the Java and Bedrock versions of the game. Snow layers can be obtained with the Silk Touch Shovel in Java, but not in Bedrock. And path blocks can be obtained in Bedrock, but not in Java. Next, let's look at the Fortune Axe. The only use of the Fortune Axe is obtaining melon slices from melon blocks. And even with Fortune 3, just 6.375 slices drop on average from each block. So if you're going to craft the slices back into blocks, this is massively inefficient, and you should instead use Silk Touch on the melon blocks. However, if the slices are what you need, like for crafting glistering melon slices, the Fortune Axe is better than nothing. A basic automatic melon farm can also solve this efficiency problem. In addition to lossless melon block collection, the Silk Touch Axe is useful for the manual farming of giant mushrooms and beekeeping. It is also handy for reusing wood-based blocks that otherwise disintegrate and lose some of their crafting ingredients when broken without Silk Touch. Now let's turn to the Fortune Pickaxe. This is the most well-known application of the Fortune enchantment, and for good reason. All of the valuable minerals can be obtained at much higher rates thanks to the Fortune Pickaxe. Last but certainly not least, we have the Silk Touch Pickaxe. When mining, players often collect their ore blocks with Silk Touch, as the numerous drops produced by Fortune can quickly clog up inventory space. Mining with Silk Touch is also great for getting stone or deep slate instead of their cobbled variants. The Silk Touch Pickaxe is also used for obtaining live coral blocks, crimson and warped nihilium, and the three types of ice. Fortune and Silk Touch also affect these blocks, which can be broken by any tool. We've now looked at the specific uses of each of the 8 tool enchantment combinations, so let's summarize. Which of these do we really need, and are there any that aren't worth the cost of crafting and enchanting them? Well, the answers may depend on how you play the game. The Fortune Hoe is great for manual tree farming, and personally, I think it's worth the cost. Tree farming can be semi-automated, of course, but unless you have tree farms for every type of wood that you need, or a universal tree farm, you will probably still need to do manual farming occasionally. The Silk Touch Hoe is essential for collecting skulk-based materials and working with vibrations. But if you don't plan to do any of that, or if the warden terrifies you, don't make a Silk Touch Hoe. The Fortune Shovel. Who needs flint anyway? Don't bother. The Silk Touch Shovel, however, is pretty much essential. You may even want a few extras if you can afford them. You'll never see another useless piece of flint in your inventory. The Fortune Axe is not particularly useful. If you really need a lot of glistering melon slices for brewing, just build an automatic melon farm or trade with a farmer. I wouldn't go so far as to say the Silk Touch Axe is essential, but since you'll need some sort of axe anyway, it might as well have Silk Touch. You'll probably regret not having this tool. The Fortune Pickaxe and Silk Touch Pickaxe are both essential. They are by far the most useful of the enchanted tools. Having extra Silk Touch Pickaxes as backups is a huge time saver if you can afford them. If you add mending to your Fortune Pickaxe, you'll only ever need one, as it will repair itself with the XP you get from ores. Personally, I tend to keep my Fortune Pickaxe in my ender chest when I don't need it, and I never go anywhere without a Silk Touch Pickaxe on my hotbar. Please share your thoughts or questions in the comments below. Which tools do you think are over or underappreciated? Should I cover other incompatible enchantments in a future video? Let me know. If you thought this video was helpful or interesting, share it with a friend. And subscribe to catch my upcoming video on pillager farming. I know the whole like, comment, subscribe spiel is a total cliche, but it really does help a small channel like mine when you interact with the video. Thanks for watching, I'm the Tuned Cube, and this has been Cube Figured.